Google Pixel 9 is the latest compact Android flagship, and S24 is already half a year old and comes in two different variants, Snapdragon for North America and China and Exynos for the rest of the world. In this video, I will start with the speed test and then move to the battery, thermals and performance test. The result will show us which chipset is the best for Android phones, Exynos 2400, Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 or Tensor G4. I am Mo, a scientist and computer science university lecturer, and I always try my best to test the phones in the same conditions. First, I use a lux meter to set all the phones to the same brightness, 700 nits to be exact. The S24 Snapdragon is always on the left side, the Google Pixel 9 is in the middle, and the Samsung Galaxy S24 is on the right side. All phones are charged 100%, and the ambient temperature is around 30 degrees Celsius, around 90 degrees Fahrenheit. I also ran the app that I wrote, which from top to bottom shows the battery percentage, temperature, RAM utilization, signal strength, CPU utilization, and power consumption in units of watts. I decided to start with a speed test. To be fair, this test is not scientific since I cannot guarantee my fingers land on the same milliseconds. Also, it's not necessarily about the chipset, but more about the RAM optimization, animations, and other factors. Nevertheless, in general, it does feel like S24 Snapdragon is a tad faster, followed up by the Pixel 9 and then the S24 Exynos. There were some occasions when Pixel 9 was loading the application faster, and that was when I tried to open Adobe Rush. With YouTube, Snapdragon came first, followed by Exynos and Pixel 9. In other scenarios, such as opening the Subway Surfers game, Snapdragon was the first, then Pixel 9, then S24 Exynos. There was instances like opening Google Chrome. Both S24s were almost identical, and Pixel 9 loaded the application later. Again, see the result with a grain of salt. For me, all of them are fast enough. Pixel 9 has more RAM though, around 12 GB. This can make opening applications faster in the long term, since the phone can hold more processes in RAM in the background, which makes launching things faster. I started the battery test by playing YouTube short. I disconnected all three phones from Wi-Fi and connected to 5G also. All of them are on mute and connected to the same network, A1 in Austria. Before the test started, a Snapdragon was slightly warmer, 1 degree higher than the rest. All of them are still at 100% battery left. I'm also counting the time with the watch on the left side. After around an hour of watching Daria for 45 minutes on repeat, the S24 Snapdragon was at 94%, the Pixel 9 at 97%, and the S24 Exynos at 93%. The temperature of S24 Exynos was 1 degree higher than the Snapdragon and 1.5 degrees higher than Pixel 9. Pixel 9 continued to surprise me with its efficiency, considering it does not even have a vapor chamber. Then, I started to play YouTube videos with the exact resolution on all three phones. After around 45 minutes, the S24 Snapdragon reached 89%, the Pixel 9 reached 91%, and the Galaxy S24 Exynos had 86% battery left. This time, Pixel 9 and S24 Exynos were around the same temperature, while S24 Snapdragon was 1 degree cooler than both of them. After that, I decided to turn on the phone's front camera and film it at 4K 30 frames per second. From my experience, Pixel phones use more power when taking videos than at least S24 Exynos. I guess the machine learning pipeline is heavier on Pixel than S24. After around 2 hours of screen time, the Galaxy S24 Snapdragon was 82%, the Pixel 9 reached 84%, and Exynos had 78% battery left. Again, Exynos and Pixel were around the same temperature, but Snapdragon was 1 degree cooler than both. I then decided to push the phones to their limits by exporting the video we had just taken in Adobe Rush. But unfortunately, something unexpected happened. Adobe Rush was running okay on a Snapdragon, but extremely slow on Exynos and did not run on Pixel 9. At first, I thought it was a bug, so I closed the application, cleared the cache, and waited for phones to cool down to rerun it. But the same thing happened again. That said, it is not necessarily Samsung or Google's fault. Adobe should fix its app for rendering on these phones. I then moved to play Subway Surfers with three phones, which was an impossible task. After 20 minutes, for the first time, a Snapdragon got hotter, followed by the S24 Exynos, and finally Pixel 9 was the coolest. It is said 1 degree cooler than the Snapdragon, an outstanding achievement. Then I moved to the most extreme test for the phones, Google Meet on 5G. This test is very heavy on a phone since it has to use the camera, encode it, and send it back over the network while simultaneously receiving two media files, decoding them, and showing them on the display. The test took less than 20 minutes, but as you can see, Exynos completely burned and reached 47.5 degrees Celsius, which is 117 Fahrenheit. Pixel got to 44, which is 112, and the Snapdragon got to almost 43 degrees, which is 109 Fahrenheit. S24 Snapdragon is 66%, Pixel 9 is 70%, and S24 Exynos is 58% battery left. Before we move to performance and benchmark test, let's analyze these results. We look into two important categories, power consumption unit watts and temperature, and the power consumption chart shows the S24 Snapdragon is red, the Pixel 9 with Tensor G4 is green, and the S24 Exynos is blue. In the beginning, during the speed test, Pixel used significantly less power than S24. Moving to YouTube Shorts, the S24 Snapdragon used the least power, followed by the Pixel and S24 Exynos. During the long YouTube video, Snapdragon used the least, followed by S24 Exynos, and then Pixel 9 used the most energy. During heavy tasks, the S24 Snapdragon was again the best, followed by Exynos and Pixel 9. But at the same time, the reason S24 stayed lower was because it got very hot, the CPU started to throttle, and the phone dimmed the screen. If you look at the average consumption, you will see that S24 Snapdragon was the more efficient, followed by the Pixel 9, and unfortunately, the S24 Exynos is still very inefficient despite all the updates. This is apparent in the second chart, which is temperature one. In the beginning, during light tasks, Pixel 9 was the coolest, followed by Snapdragon and Exynos. Exynos stayed hot during the whole time. Between Pixel 9 and S24 Snapdragon, there is a tie. If you look at the average temperature, the S24 Snapdragon and Pixel 9 are almost identical, while Exynos is around 1 degree hotter on average. I continue the test by running the AnTuTu benchmark. Since all phones are hot, the AnTuTu test is going to be affected, and we will see a lower result than usual. In this specific situation, Snapdragon achieved an impressive 1.6 million, followed by Exynos with around 1.4 million, and then Pixel got 800,000 and 30K. Most likely Pixel throttles at a lower temperature, and that's why we see a rather low score here. All phones were connected to Wi-Fi during this part of the test. I then left the phones on 5G for 20 hours. By the end of the 20 hours, Galaxy S24 Snapdragon lost 14%, Pixel 9 lost 13%, and S24 Exynos lost 16% battery. I then ran the heaviest benchmark of all, which is the 3D bench, extreme stress test. This benchmark will naturally drain more battery from S24 because there are more powerful chipsets. By the end of the benchmark, Exynos was 1 degree hotter than Snapdragon, and Pixel was 2 to 3 degrees cooler than the other two. At the same time, as predicted, Pixel 9 got the lowest score. Snapdragon got 4,900, Exynos got 4,080, and Pixel got 2,500. Both S24 has one major frame drop. To run the batteries to the ground, I decided to run more YouTube Shorts. Since the battery was not draining fast enough, I then ran YouTube videos that used more battery together with some random animations on Google Chrome. By the end of this part of the test, the S24 Snapdragon was at 23%, Pixel 9 at 32%, and S24 Exynos at 7% battery. Also, the S24 Exynos was 2 degrees hotter than both the Pixel 9 and S24 Snapdragon. Then I ran Google Meet in the background while playing YouTube videos in the foreground. This is, by the way, what I love about Android, which is multitasking. As usual, the last percentages on Galaxy phones run fast. Exynos tried to dim the screen, but I turned it back on. Also, Exynos is now 4 to 5 degrees hotter than the other two phones. Finally, at 4 hours and 44 minutes of screen on time while burning at 47 degrees Celsius, which is 117 Fahrenheit, Galaxy S24 was the first one to leave the scene. Rest in peace. The other two phones continue to battle. It is apparent that the S24 Snapdragon is going to be the second, but considering it has a much smaller battery capacity, which is 4000 versus 4700 from Pixel 9, it is impressive. It is true that S24 Snapdragon has an LTPO screen that helps save battery, but at the same time, the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 is much more powerful chipset and it's more power hungry. Finally, after a hard battle, S24 left this world at 5 hours and 34 minutes of screen time. Pixel 9 stayed uncontested on the battlefield and tried to break a record for Pixel phones. It is really impressive since the Pixel 8 usually lasts shorter than S24 Snapdragon, so Google did something right in this generation. After 6 hours and 33 minutes, Google Pixel 9 also left the table. That's 1 hour and 35 minutes more than S24 Exynos and 1 hour more than S24 Snapdragon. So the real question is, which phone should you pick? I would say, if you don't mind the extra weight of the Pixel 9 and the fact that it is slightly bigger, the Pixel 9 can be a more reasonable choice, especially compared to S24 Exynos. That said, the S24 can be bought at a much lower price in retail right now, and it is also much more compact. From my own experience, sometimes I forget that the S24 is even on my pocket, while you can feel the weight of Pixel 9. You may also wonder why I didn't test outdoor activities this time. The reason is that I did a day-in-the-life comparison of these two phones in another video that you can watch next. I hope you liked the video. Write down in the comments what comparison you want to see next. Thanks for tuning into Techmo, and I will see you in the next one.